Meteor Client is the most popular hack client for Anarchy servers. So here's how to install it and use every part of the client to its fullest potential. So to start off, we need to download two things. Fabric MC, then you'll see fabricmc.net, and we'll click on download and download for Windows. Meteor Client, and then it should be meteorclient.com, and we'll download one of these right now, Meteor Client 1.21.8. Cool, we'll download 1.21.8, wait 5 seconds, awesome. Now we'll click on skip, and it should start to download. Run Fabric. So now we want to match to the Minecraft version with the Meteor Client version. This is 1.21.8, Minecraft version is 1.21.8. Awesome, we can click on install. We'll go down here, app data, percentage, we will see app data, click on enter, roaming.minecraft. Mods, and we will now drag in Meteor Client. Sadly, this is 1.21.4. Now we can take this and put in Meteor Client. Now with that done, we can open up Minecraft like normal, and you can see Fabric Loader 1.21.8, and that's the one we have Meteor Client for. So we'll click on play and play. If you get error code 1, then double check the version of Fabric and the mods in the Fabric folder. Now when you open up Minecraft, it should look like this. So now I'll join a single player world. The way you open this up is by opening your keyboard and right shifting. It will open it up just like that. If we hover over something like Anchor, it'll explain what it does. So Anchor automatically places and breaks the spawn anchors to harm entity. Alright, we'll click on to turn it on and click on it to turn it off. So if we right click it, you can see the start and it'll show up in the favorites. So if I click on exit, click on here, you see the favorite it turns on over here. Awesome. It'll explain what it does, the name, and the different things it can do. We'll hover over these and it'll explain what it does. So targeting is the radius in which players are targeted. Now let's say this, we want it to 5. Alright. What if we want to reset it but we don't know which is? What's the reset? We'll just click on here and it'll reset it just like that. So target priority is how to select the players to target. We'll click on here and it's a drop down and then you pick on one of them. Let's say lowest distance. We refresh it. It automatically goes back to lowest health. And this bind, we have it currently at minus. Let's do gray accent. You can see auto aura is now on gray accent, and if we click on the grave accent, it'll turn it on and off just like that. Let's right shift and we can use it to search. So let's do free cam, click on here. Now you can see we have free cam going, and if we right shift and search up free cam, we can turn it off again. Now we're on to the config set. We can set the custom font or turn it off with just Minecraft. So now what kind of font can we pick? Let's pick impact. If we picked impact, it's the impact font. Ink free, which is here, but personally I don't like either of these, so let's reset it back to its normal font. Cool. Now with those two, now with the title, screen splash, and credit, if we disconnect and go back, you can see Meteor Client and that. But if we rejoin the server and we turn those off, let's do config. Let's turn these off real quick and then disconnect. You can see it's now gone. So let's connect back to the server. You can see it's the title, but if we set this to what we want, subscribe, you can see it changes with it. Now, what about friend color? Well, we can edit that and change it to what we want. I'm just gonna do rainbow so that it constantly changes. So now, how does that work? Well, if we go to friends and my alt is sapphire, we will now go to friends, sapphire with 3. There we go, we added it, we wait for it to load, you can see it, same face, same name. We go to modules, ESP, and we turn it on, you can see he starts changing colors. We go to the config, and let's put him on this side. Whatever my character is with this, it's the exact same. So if I wanted to, let's say, turn that off and turn it to black, it's now black, white, it's now white, yellow, it's now yellow. And we can switch it up how we want. Alright. Now, hidden modules, we can hide modules. We'll do air jump. You can see air jump right here. Select a module, air jump, and we select that, and we go back to the modules, you can see movement air jump is not there anymore. But if we reset this and go back, now we have air jump in movement again. Module search count. So we can search up module. Let's do 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And right here you can see there's 8. Now if we bring it down to 1 and go 3, there's just 1. Or if we want to max it out, we can, and there will be 12. I'm not going to count the 12, but I mean, if you want to, you can. Prefix it. This is a dot. So if we go here, click on dot, help, it will show the media client add-on, the help stuff. The one we can do with it. Awesome. So now if we go here and we change it to, let's say, this, not the slash mark, actually, because that's too obvious. Let's do the minus sign. Now if we open up check, do the minus, help. The help works, but if we do the dot, it won't show up. But the scale, we can go down scale, we can go up scale. Reset that, because if it's smaller, it becomes smaller. If it's bigger, it becomes bigger. Okay, I was able to reset that. The module alignment, they're in the center, and we can set it for the left. And if we go back here, they're on the left. If we go over here, we can click the right, and we can go on the right. So category icons, let's set that to left, because I like that. It now has the category icons just like that. And if we go back to GUI, we can hide HUD, which will hide my hand and the bottom. Oh, and those two. If we turn it back on, and there we go. Ancient color, it'll change this. So if we rainbow it, you can see it's now rainbow. And if we go back, that's rainbow. And these are also rainbow, which is very cool. Checkbox color, it'll set the checkbox. So if we click here, we can see the checkbox is changing colors. So let's reset that. The plus sign, it'll be the plus sign. So if we go here to block or block ESP, works not or, we can see these plus signs are now changing colors. That will be the same thing with the minus color too. Favorite color, that one, we can go over here, turn that on, right click, and we can see this star is now changing colors. Now I'll just show you two more, which is text color, background color, and outline color. So the text color, we can change the text. So if I want it red, you can see it's now red. White, black, it's now black. And we can just change it, or we can just straight up rainbow it. Let's put it back to white. Background color, we can edit the background color to how we like. If we do that, it changes it and continues it. The issue is when it's yellow, it's very hard to read. So let's wait for it to get to yellow. There we go. As you can see, it's not that easy to read these variables like that. So blue is actually pretty nice, but let's go back, let's reset that. Now it's just depressing. Outline color, it's the outline of these boxes. As you can see, it's changing colors with these two. Now we have the HUD. We can set the custom font, because these are what these are for. So custom font is back to Minecraft, but it's hard to see. Hidden menus, so if we turn that on, or we click on E, they're hidden. But if we go right back to the HUD and then turn it back off and we click on E, you can see they are still there. So let's go and let's refresh that back to off. Text scale, I mean, it's the scale of the text stuff. Text color, you can edit the text color, so it's red. That's what those are. Cool, let's go back. This is these ones, so like the numbers, you can see as I change it, it changes it. So if I want it to be a light blue, I can do that, or have it a black. Cool. Now these two, I don't know what they do, so I'll just skip over them. Borders and border snap, these are for the editor. So if I go here and click on edit, I can edit it just like this, and it snaps pretty well. But if I go here and max out the border and snap and just click on it, it's much more persistent with what it's doing. So if I just go back and reset these and click on edit and bring this back up here, I can do that very easily. With friends, I showed you how friends work earlier in the video. Macros, we can create a macro and set a diamond give and add. Now add the message. I'm gonna do slash give a Vinny craftable a diamond 3 times. Let's set this the equal sign and create. Now if I click on equal, it gives me 3 diamonds. And as I click on it, as I click on equal, it will do the macro in chat. So let's do equal. Every time I click, you can see it's giving me 3. And we have profiles. If we create, we can create a name for this. So I'm going to create the name under 5b5t. And when we join 5b5t.org, it will load this up. So we'll just do the HUD macros module waypoint and create profile. Now let's create, and let's do one for 6b6t now. 6b60.org, create, and now it's set for that. But if we disconnect and join 5b5t, we were already on 5b5t. 6b6t, it should have more with, yep, there we go, the HUD on this one. But then if we disconnect and join 5b5t, it shouldn't be there anymore. Yup, there we go. And then if we right click, it would be over here. HUD, can we edit and snap these? Yeah, there's 3 of them. Now the final 2 we'll go over are proxies and accounts. Proxies are just an IP map. If you are on an anarchy, so you don't really need that. You don't really need to learn about that. You just need your accounts, because they won't really ban you for doing anything because it's anarchy. Accounts, you get to add your cracked account, alternate, or your Microsoft account. There are some cracked anarchy accounts, but once they're gone, I wouldn't recommend using them. I just recommend using Microsoft for your other accounts.